Hello, everybody. Welcome to the wrap-up week four, Matt. And it's a wild week, a lot of wild games and a lot of great matchups as we get closer and closer to district play.
That's right. And as always, District 3, 4A is wild. Tascosa off this week. No 5A action in the local viewing area. But we do have a lot of 4A action. Or not a lot. We got a couple teams that are off. But the games that we do have, big matchups, including one tomorrow that we'll look at. But first, let's go ahead and go down south.
Borger and Randall. Borger 0-4, Randall 4-0 heading into the game. And we'll start you with Borger's Colton Hunter. He's picked off, though, by Logan Britton. Offensively, defensively, Britton getting it done for the Raiders. A pick six there makes it 14-0. Randall, still the first. Kendrick Freeman gets it for the Borger offense and takes it up the middle for a nice hard run on the play. Borger will be okay when they stop playing these bigger schools and these bigger powerhouses, I promise. But Randall, just too much in this one. Colin Bowen around the outside,
Superman.
61 yards on the touchdown. 21-0 Randall. They started that drive on their own four. 49-6 is your final score there. Randall, big winners. All right, let's go to Lubbock, Monterey, and Caprock. Another wild one. In the second, it's already to 20-12. Michael Guerrero looking, finding Tavi Jeffries. Jeffries, not done yet. A nice move there. Gaining some extra yards on the play, and then Guerrero again, he's going to reward Jeffries. This time in the end zone for the touchdown. Nice play. Touchdown makes it 20-20 at that point. Still in the second, still 20-20. Ensuing drive, in fact. Remember Trevon Benton from that game last week we saw at Kimbrough? This guy is a load running back, and he just punishes defenses. You can see right there, tough runs. He had almost 200 yards in the first half. Still 20 all. Later in the drive, Evan Gaylor takes it on the inside. A nice job just to hold on to that ball. He gets it to the 5-yard line. Right there close to the end zone, the next play. Matt, I give it to Ben. If I'm Monterey and I'm close to the end zone, I give it to the big man.
That's the smart decision.
That's what they do, too. He didn't even need to use his power on that one. Untouched into the end zone, 27-20. How about this score? Take a breath. Over-unders, I'm going to guess they went over. 75-61. Lubbock Monterey over Caprock, a wild one. Let's find out what happened. Joining us now on the phone from the Texas Panhandle Sports Network, Phil Woodall was at this game. And Phil, take a breath, relax a little bit, because you haven't had a chance. What a game. Nothing unexpected, though, I guess, with these two offenses.
Not at all, or maybe not much to expect because of the two defenses, because they couldn't stop either one. You know, the final score is 75-61. If your curfew was 10:30, this game didn't end till 10:52, so you wouldn't have seen the last 22 minutes of the ball game. But it was wild and crazy. You talked about Trevon Benton, 34 carries, 371 yards. He scored 6 touchdowns in the game. Michael Guerrero threw for 7 touchdown passes. Also ran one in from a yard out, and he had 477 yards passing. And the big difference in the ball game is Caprock, I believe, had 5 or 6 turnovers, and Monterey converted those into some points, and that really was the big difference in the ball game tonight. So, you know, Monterey is going to be a force down there in 4-4A, and I guarantee in 3-4A, all 6 of the teams in that district, you don't go to sleep on any of them at all, because it's going to be very, very tough, and it's going to be a great district season between 3-4A, and then when you get into bye district against 4-4A, we've already seen some potential matchups. It's going to be great.
Phil, one more question for you. You see this game, and let's look down the road. Caprock is going to face some big-time running attacks in 3-4A. Quickly, can they and do they have the ability to get these defenders in to stop some of these running attacks, because it doesn't get easier with and Randall.
And Jacob, they're going to have to make some big adjustments. To me, their most consistent defensive player all season long has been Jose Franco. He made some big stops on the big guy at Benton tonight, and he made some big stops a few weeks ago when they played up in Borger. He's the guy that's got to do the lead on that, but they've got to have help from other people. They're not getting the tackles that they need. The tackles are being broken against the Caprock defense, and quite frankly, it's going to be their downfall. They can outscore anybody, guarantee you that. But defensively, they've got to cut some points down and stop the running attacks, because we know how good Colin Bowen is at Randall. We know how good the wing tee offense of Amarillo High. I really like Canyon. That's a very diverse team with their quarterback, Blake Weaver. Can't forget the kid up in Dumas. And we all know how explosive Palladora can be. So it's going to be a crazy District 3-4A, and you don't want to fall asleep on anybody in that district.
Couldn't agree more, Phil. Thanks so much for joining us. Now let's get to some more District 3-4A. Dumas, Plainview. Shamar Jennings with a 38-yard gain for the Bulldogs. Same drive. Daniel Miller. This time he does it on the ground. Takes the handoff. Little option action. 7-0 Plainview. But Dumas, a good offense. Rylan Gerber, deep to Matt Clemens. What a great catch. Play of the week candidate.
That was nice.
That was full extension, folks. Same drive. Nathan Blackwell. He takes the handoff. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown. However, Plainview edges the Dumas Demons 39-35. Plainview, your victors in that one. Herford and Lubbock Cooper. Second quarter, 13-7 Cooper when Ryan Fetter takes it inside the 2-yard line. Then Chandler Patterson would punch it in. 20-7 Cooper. But Herford not laying down in this one. Ray Martinez to Toby Garza, a big game. Look at him get up the field, getting some blocking downfield too. Just before the half, it's Martinez. He gets sacked, he fumbles the ball, Cooper recovers. Cooper played some good defense in this one. 20-14, Cooper gets the victory over the White Faces.
One for you tomorrow that we talked about a little bit ago, we kind of foreshadowed. Amarillo High taking on Stephenville. That one in Snyder, they're playing a neutral site game there. So get ready for that one. It should be exciting. Both of those teams moved down. Amarillo High to 4A, Stephenville to 3A, and they're both powers in their respective classifications now. So we're very excited about that one as well. We didn't forget about you, Palladora. We are getting that video in as we speak. We have it. Palladora against Friendship, a very tough matchup on the road. We will have it, hopefully right after this commercial break, and we'll get that for you coming up in a little bit. Stick with us, Dons fans, as well as the rest of the High Plains. We'll be back on the wrap-up.